Welcome everybody to this St. Peter's All Age Palm Sunday service. I don't know what your week has been like. It may have been great or it may have been difficult. Anyway, congratulations, you've got through it. I really love the story that at one surgery in Bristol, the staff were finding it so stressful that they arranged a few sessions at midday to go out into the car park and all have a dance to some music. And they were only going to have a few sessions. And they suddenly noticed that over the fence was a care home. And in all the windows of the care home, all the elderly were joining in dancing. And so it happens now every single day that all those from the surgery are dancing at midday, and those in the care home that have got windows facing that way, they're all dancing. So there are all sorts of ways and stories about good news amidst the bad news. And I hope in the week you've had, there's been some good news and there's good news in the week ahead. Just to let you know, on our website, where it says children and youth, every week there are all sorts of resources for families so that complement what we do. So there's even more to do and they're really great. Now for this service, if you want to join in with some of the things going on, I would love you to have a coat, and as well as a coat, to have a scarf, might have a hat, or if you've made a palm leaf or you have a big leaf, to have those ready. So you may want to pause while you're watching now and go and get your coat and anything else. It's Palm Sunday. There's going to be some waving going on. Well, if you've gone away and you've come back, great to be back. We're going to start now. So whether you're wearing shirt and tie, whether you're wearing pajamas or something in between, let's, as God family, gather to worship. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Let us pray. King Jesus, we welcome you as you come to us this Palm Sunday. Come to bless our worship. Come to bless our communities. Come and bless our land and our world. Come to us as we come to you and bring you our praise and our prayer. To help us in prayer right at the start, I encourage you to hold your hand up there, and we're just going to pray for others in the world as well as ourselves. So I've done this at St. Peter's off and on. So if you take your thumb, and as we do that, if you would, let's pray for leaders, because these are strong. We pray for leaders that God would give them wisdom at this time and help them with such difficult choices. Now we move on to the next finger, and holding on to that, we pray for those who are closest to us, dear family, dear friends. We now go to the middle finger, the longest one. So let's remember those who are further away and we can't see at this time. And now we move on to the next finger, fourth one to hold on to, and let's remember those who are not well, those who are having difficulty, or those who are really sad for some reason. And finally, the ickle finger, the little finger, we hold that And now let's pray for ourselves. It may be there's something you really want to bring to the God who loves you about your own life. And everyone said, Amen. It's time to praise God.
This reading is taken from Matthew chapter 21, starting at verse 1, the International Children's Bible version. Jesus enters Jerusalem as a king. Jesus and his followers were coming closer to Jerusalem, but first they stopped at Bethphage, at the hill called the Mount of Olives. From there, Jesus sent two of his followers into the town. He said to them, Go to the town you can see there. When you enter it, you will find a donkey tied there with its colt. Untie them and bring them to me. If anyone asks you why you are taking the donkeys, tell him the master needs them. He will send them back soon. This was to make clear the full meaning of what the prophet said. Tell the people of Jerusalem, your king is coming to you. He is gentle and riding on a donkey. He is on the colt of a donkey. The followers went and did what Jesus told them to do. They brought the donkey and the colt to Jesus. They laid their coats on the donkeys and Jesus sat on them. Many people spread their coats on the road before Jesus. Others cut branches from the trees and spread them on the road. Some of the people were walking ahead of Jesus, others were walking behind him. All the people were shouting, Praise to the Son of David! God bless the one who comes in the name of the Lord! Praise to God in heaven! Then Jesus went into Jerusalem. The city was filled with excitement. The people asked, Who is this man? The crowd answered, This man is Jesus. He is the prophet from the town of Nazareth in Galilee. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Hi, everyone. Lovely to see you again. When I was a child, we used to have a kind of dressing up box, and there were all sorts of things in it, and there were hats rather like these. So here we got a top hat. Here, oh no, that was a bowler hat, sorry. And now a top hat. Now a rather greatest showman kind of hat. A sombrero for lovely hot warm times. And then from the Middle East, a kind of headdress. Here we go. Like that. Or I suppose it was worn over the head. So all sorts of things. We used to dress up and we used to act things out. But there weren't only things for the head. There were coats. And so I've got a coat. I asked you to get a coat. And I hope you've got one. I invite you to put it on now. Here we go. Coat on. There we go. And later on, you know, if you've got a palm leaf to wave, have that ready. If you've got a scarf, here's a scarf. Now this is a Liverpool one, so that might be a bit sort of partisan. So I've got the nearest to an Everton one, but you might want to have neither of those. So here's another one, and you'll have your opportunity to wave it around in the air. But coats on, here we go. Now, in Jesus' day, I think there are probably three reasons for wearing a coat. The first would have been, and feel free to join in with my actions, the first would have been if it was really windy. And when it's really windy, of course, you need to do your coat up. I'm going to do mine up. I wonder if you're going to do yours up. Here we go. Oh. Right. Oh, that's the first reason when it's really windy. The second reason, I think, could be in a sandstorm. And when it's a sandstorm, the wind is blowing and sand gets everywhere. Oh. If you've got a hood, put your hood up. Oh. The third reason, so we've got wind, sandstorm. The third one, I think, is because it's really hot. Now, it might seem crazy to have a cloak on when you're really hot. But when the sun comes and you are just baking, it's actually quite nice to have something to cover you so that you're protected. Well, that's the introduction to the coat. So, have your palms and your leaves and your scarves ready. We're going to tell the story. Go back and revisit it and see what we can learn. So, first of all, Jesus and his disciples are walking towards Jerusalem, and they end up at the Mount of Olives. That's supposed to be a tree. And as they get near a little village with lots of little houses in, Jesus sends off two disciples to go and get a donkey and a baby donkey. And he tells them that when they go and get, I guess it might be tied to a tree, and they are to untie it and bring it back to Jesus. But Jesus says, if someone stops you, say that the Lord needs it. And I just want to imagine that someone comes out and sees those two disciples coming to get the donkey and the baby donkey and says, oi, what are you doing? And the two disciples say, Jesus needs the donkey and the little donkey. And I like to imagine the man said, anyone's a friend of Jesus's is a friend of mine. Go on, take them. Well, they take them back and they see Jesus. I invite you to take off your coat. And they take the donkey there and they see that the donkey, I wonder whether it's a bit bony. And so they take their coats and they lay them over the donkey. Take off your coat and lay it on your legs. And that way, without a saddle, Jesus was going to be really, really comfortable. Well, they head back. Jesus, the disciples, but Jesus is on a donkey. And I wonder about the little donkey. I think the little donkey is toddling along afterwards. Clip, clop, clip, clop. Well, you're now going to be the crowd. So would you put your coat back on? And as they head off to Jerusalem, suddenly they see a great crowd and they're shouting, ready with your scarves, with your palms, with anything else. And they shout, Hosanna! 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 Hosanna to the Son of David! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord! Well done for joining in, especially you on the sofa. Well, they treated Jesus as a king. They didn't have a red carpet to roll out, so they took off their coats. You take off your coat. And they laid their coats before Jesus. So it was like saying, welcome, Jesus. It was like saying, we worship you, Jesus. It was like saying, Jesus, you've come to save us and we're ready to serve you. And on this Palm Sunday, you and me are invited to welcome Jesus. Hosanna! We're invited to worship Jesus. Hosanna! And we're invited to serve him. To live not only with our lips, but with the whole of our lives. Well, that's the scene we get on Palm Sunday, and we're just about to go into Holy Week, where we'll come to Good Friday, and then we'll come to Easter. And during that time, the crowd will reject Jesus, and the disciples will fail Jesus. And they'll feel very sad about that. But Jesus will come and he'll cover them with his love, rather like putting a lovely coat around you. So he'll cover them with forgiveness, hallelujah, with comfort, hallelujah, with courage, hallelujah, with strength, hallelujah, and with amazing love that knows no end. So knowing God's love for us, we can then, rather like putting a coat round someone, give them God's love in acts of kindness. So maybe this week there might be an opportunity for you to give an act of kindness to someone else. I wonder if you can think what it is. Let me start you off with a few ideas. You've probably done them already, but maybe you need to do them again. Maybe you'll have the opportunity and the imagination to do something else. It may be that you draw a rainbow of hope and put it in the window. You've probably done that already. What about another one? Maybe you can just give someone a smile. Maybe you can think of a lovely way to make someone smile. It may be you can send a caring text or ring a friend. Do you know, I think the wonderful thing about acts of kindness is when we receive them, oh, it's like being wrapped up on a cold day with the love of God. And every time you do an act of kindness, it'll be like then, feeling as though someone has wrapped them up and they feel really cozy, warm and loved. May you have a really wonderful week full of God's love. God bless.
Such a lot when you got not a lot. What? Be happy.
This reading is taken from Matthew chapter 21, starting at verse 1, the International Children's Bible version. Jesus enters Jerusalem as a king. Jesus and his followers were coming closer to Jerusalem, but first they stopped at Bethphage, at the hill called the Mount of Olives. From there, Jesus sent two of his followers into the town. He said to them, "Go to the town you can see there. When you enter it, you will find a donkey tied there with its colt. Untie them and bring them to me. If anyone asks you why you are taking the donkeys, tell him the master needs them. He will send them back soon." This was to make clear the full meaning of what the prophet said. "Tell the people of Jerusalem, your king is coming to you. He is gentle and riding on a donkey. He is on the colt of a donkey." The followers went and did what Jesus told them to do. They brought the donkey and the colt to Jesus. They laid their coats on the donkeys and Jesus sat on them. Many people spread their coats on the road before Jesus. Others cut branches from the trees and spread them on the road. Some of the people were walking ahead of Jesus. Others were walking behind him. All the people were shouting, "Praise to the Son of David. God bless the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Praise to God in heaven." Then Jesus went into Jerusalem. The city was filled with excitement. The people asked, "Who is this man?" The crowd answered, "This man is Jesus. He is the prophet from the town of Nazareth in Galilee." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
I wonder what it was like to be there on that day that we call Palm Sunday. Jesus and his disciples arrive at the Mount of Olives, and Jesus sends two disciples to find a donkey. The two disciples are to untie it and bring it to him, and if anyone asks, they should simply say the master needs it. That's exactly what happens. They bring the donkey to Jesus with no saddle. Some of the disciples put their cloaks on the donkey, and off they start down the road that leads to Jerusalem. The disciples walk with Jesus, and there's the sound of the donkey's hooves clomping on the path. The wind blows through the olive trees. And then they hear something ahead. A crowd is gathering. Children are shouting. Palm trees are waving. People are taking their coats off and spreading them on the road, welcoming Jesus as if he's a king. Confusion changes to excitement. Everyone seems to be shouting and dancing and praising God. Hosannas fill the air, proclaiming, "God saves." Someone reminds one of the disciples of words from the prophet Zechariah. "Look, your king is coming to you, humble and riding on a donkey." Jesus comes in peace, so different from the way that Herod arrives when he comes to the city from Caesarea Philippi, where his headquarters are. He enters on a mighty war horse in the name of Caesar, not the Lord, surrounded by chariots and swords and spears and bows, inspiring fear, fear of suffering and of death. Jesus' coming will inevitably mean for Jesus various things. First, suffering. And in his suffering, we get a picture that Jesus suffers all our pain, all our aloneness, and all our griefs. Surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. May you know his compassion at this time. Jesus comes to die. We'll remember that on Good Friday, of course. As Jesus bears our sins on the cross to bring us to know God. May you know him afresh as your saviour, or know him as your saviour for the very first time. Jesus died and rose again, and in his rising, everyone who encounters him finds more faith because they trust him, more hope because they trust him, more love because they behold his love and experience it. Casting down the coats is for us a symbol of welcome, of worship, of offering the whole of our lives to serve him. Will you do the same this Palm Sunday to the King who comes and offer your life to the one who gives all and gave all for you. In the prodigal son story, the prodigal seeks to serve and says he's not worthy to be called the father's son, but he'll work. But then the father won't hear of it. He embraces his son as he embraces each one of us and says, put on a robe. And that robe, I believe we can read in a sense, knowing God and knowing his love for us, is a picture of the King of Kings and Lord of Lords treating us as his own princesses, his own princes. He puts us in royal robes. And so the response I find to what I've shared and what I've reflected on are the words of this wonderful hymn with which I end, and then I'll say a prayer of blessing. King of Kings, Majesty, God of Heaven, living in me, gentle Saviour, closest friend, strong deliverer, beginning and end, all within me falls at your throne. Your Majesty, I can but bow. I lay my all before you now. In royal robes, I don't deserve. I live to serve your Majesty. Earth and heaven worship you, love eternal, faithful and true, who brought the nations, ransomed souls, brought this sinner near to your throne. All within me cries out in praise. Your Majesty, I can but bow, I lay my all before you now. In royal robes I don't deserve, I live to serve your Majesty. And so may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be with each one of you and all those you love, this day and forevermore. Amen.